Hey, what's going on? It's Azura here. Today we're going to dive deep into all the changes the upcoming 5.2 patch will bring to all the tanks and anti-tank gadgets. Many tank players felt that pushing objectives is a monumental task, and they would rather sit far away from the objective because of the many anti-tank gadgets infantry have that can instantly destroy them. DICE has heard these complaints, and the intention of these changes is to empower tankers to play the objective among other reasons. So the upcoming 5.2 update coming in early December will bring a complete overhaul for tanks and anti-tank gadgets. There will be major changes to the way armor angles work, as well as a complete rebalance of the tank shells. And before showing you all the numbers, I do want to say that all of the following information has been compiled by myself, and if there are any errors of any sort, where there are typos or calculation errors, that will be on me. The raw pre-processed data is provided by DICE, and I have processed them so that they will make a little bit more sense to all of you. I've also added timestamps to different sections of the video on the various topics. Anyway, let's start with one of the biggest changes. That would be armor angling. And these will be massive changes to its mechanics. And currently, incoming shell damage highly depends on the exact angle of the tank down to the degree. There are also ricochet hits dealing as low as 1 damage. And good angle broadside hit may also sometimes be read as a bad top-down hit, and that would cause it to ricochet even if it appears to be a good hit. And DICE is trying to simplify all these angles, basically shutting me down so I can't calculate all these optimal angles anymore and making videos of it. I'm just kidding. And they also fixed the unintended effects of extremely low damage ricochet hits and getting ricochets when you're not supposed to. And in just a moment, I'm going to show you a ton of graphs comparing the damage curve of the previous version and the updated version for every single tank. The linear drop-off for all the damage curves will now be simplified by having only 2 or 3 tiers of damage depending on the tank. This was also communicated in the previous blog post from DICE stating that there are 3 tiers, and they will be ricochet, normal, or critical hits. And ricochet hits will now deal at least a decent amount of damage, and repeated ricochet hits will also now yield a higher DPS. And for example, the default Sherman M3 75mm cannon will deal a minimum of 11.6 damage to the Type 97 Chihas front if the round did ricochet, and it will no longer get those 1 damage shots anymore. And normal hits, which cover the majority of the hits, will be standardized to 1 value per round per enemy tank across a wide range of angle, and that would be typically 30 to 80 degrees on the medium tank side. It will no longer be based on the exact angle you are at on a linear line. And repeated normal hits will now give roughly the same pacing as the current version would. The baseline DICE is trying to achieve is to deal roughly 20 damage per shot to a medium tank from a medium tank on an average shot. So for example, a Panzer IV KWK-40 L48 cannon will deal 20 damage to a Valentine Mark 8 side between angles 30 and 80. And this allows for more consistency between various shots, but at the same time, there is a negative consequence to switching to the stepwise system as opposed to the linear drop system. For players who are masters of tank angling, or the ones who watched my previous videos and learned the magic 40 degree trick, this will not have as much of an advantage from angling your tank. The current system allows you to angle your tank so that the incoming round can deal as low as 0.5 times impact damage whether the round hit the front or the side. And just a quick reminder for those who don't know what these terms mean, shells have both impact damage, which is angle dependent, and blast damage, which is not. AP rounds have much more emphasis on impact damage, meaning it is much more dependent on the angle of impact. The new system will decrease the effectiveness of tank angling by having a constant 1 times impact multiplier across a wide angle. But even with these changes, it will still be important to angle your tank a little bit past 10 degrees for the most part. Otherwise, you can still take up to 1.5 times impact damage to the front or 2 times impact damage to the front tracks for most of the tanks. And this also applies to the side armor, and it will favor the players who did not previously have the discipline to precisely control their tank angle. And because of that, in a head-to-head standoff tank versus tank fight, the skill gap will decrease by a bit since the exact angle control is no longer a viable tactic. And next will be the critical hits. They will be the maximum damage you can deal to a tank, and the angles that allow for such a hit has narrowed by a significant amount. Repeated critical hits will now give roughly the same performance, if not minimally higher DPS as repeated critical hits before. But in the current system, as long as the angle is decent, you can deal a massive hit to the enemy even if it is not at the perfect angle because of the linear drop-off. With the new 5.2 system, once you're outside the most optimal angle, the impact damage multiplier will literally drop off a cliff back to the normal hits we just talked about. And to give you an example, a Panzer IV KWK 40 L48 cannon can deal 20 damage to the Valentine Mark 8 side on a normal hit at 79 degrees, but if it is hit at 81 degrees, it can deal 35 damage, and that's quite a huge increase, or decrease, depending which way you go. And the rear of the tank will remain as the weakest part of the tank with a much looser angle. The same shell can deal 44 damage to the rear of the Valentine tank as long as it is 60 degrees or more. And because of this particular change, certain tanks' front armor will now be incapable of receiving a critical hit. And those will include all versions of the Churchill tank, the Tiger tank, the Sturm Tiger, the Stuk 4, and the historical fronts of the Valentine Archer. And to circumvent this, you can aim at the tracks of these tanks to deal a critical side damage hit as long as it is past 80 degrees. The turret will also see a significant change in terms of the damage multiplier. In the current build, tank turret is sort of a fail-safe target to hit if the body of the enemy tank is at an optimal angle to deflect incoming rounds. It creates its when in doubt, hit the tank turret meta. This update will see a change to that mentality by reducing the impact damage multiplier from 1.6 times to 1 times for most tanks, meaning it will deal just as much as a normal hit on the front, side, or rear. There are of course some exceptions. For the Staghound and the Panzer 38T, its turret multiplier is now at 1.2 instead of 1.67 previously, but it's still better than the 1 time multiplier of the normal hits on the body. And for the AA tanks, it is still 1.6, so the previous tank turret meta still holds somewhat true against those tanks unless you can land a greater than 80 degree shot to any sides of its armor. And now let's show you the graphs for each of these tanks. I'm going to scroll through these, and feel free to pause the video if you want to take a closer look. But basically, the yellow line is the current system, and the blue line will be the new system. The higher the line is, the more damage it takes at that particular angle. And the left graph shows the front armor, the middle will be the side, and the graph on the right will be the rear of the tank. And as you can see, some tanks only have two tiers, and those would be the heavy tanks and the Stuk 4's front and the archer's rear for better protection. You would not be able to land the critical hits on those tanks' front armor. And after looking at these graphs for the change in angle, you may find that the blue line is generally on top of the yellow line, meaning it has a larger multiplier on average. And your first impression may suggest that tanks will be taking more damage from any given shell, or infantry, anti-tank rockets, but that is before we take a look at the massive rebalance of the damage for all the tank shells and man-portable anti-tank weapons. Overall, we see a significant reduction of the impact damage for most, if not all, AP tank shells of roughly 20% or so. And there are two shells in particular that saw a disproportionate nerf, which would be the Sherman Calliope's main gun seeing a 32% reduction, and the Sherman Heat Round seeing a 43% reduction. And with these changes, the Heat Round will still be better than anything the Japanese has, but will be nowhere as powerful as before. And not all AP rounds saw a nerf. A few actually saw a buff, and those will include the Staghound's AP rounds with the Lil Jon adapter attached with a 4% gain, the Churchill Mark 7 APC round with a 6% improvement, and the Type 97 Chiha 57mm AT round seeing a massive 50% improvement. And this is actually great. If you recall my previous Chiha review, you probably heard me say that the 57mm AT shell was disproportionately bad, and the HE shell can sometimes be better than it at hitting tanks. Then for the HE shells, none of them had a baseline 20% nerf for impact damage, and as a matter of fact, a lot of them actually saw a buff. The Panzer IV's KWK 40 L48 saw a 4% increase, the Type 97 57mm HE, the LVT, and the Kami's 37mm cannon also saw a high teens increase, The Kami's 75mm HG saw a 25% increase, and the Big Cannon on the LVT saw a 40% increase. The Hachi's main cannon saw a 70% increase, and the Churchill's 75mm HE also saw a 72% increase in impact damage. And here you can see the chart with these numbers. And with that in mind, you can see that the damage gap against tanks between HE and AP shells have drastically narrowed. That means HE shells are now closer to AP shells in terms of damage, and it will also be affected by the angle more than before. As for the howitzers, there was a small mistake in terms of the blast radius that I found, and this should be fixed in the next patch. The blast radius for 1-hit kill in 5.2 for most howitzers except for the LVT will be at 2.3 meters. It should be more like 3.1 meters. And then one of the best tanks against infantry that came with the Pacific update would be the LVT and the Kami with heavy machine gun upgrade. These will see a drastic nerf, actually doubling the amount of bullets needed to kill. The spread will also follow the coaxial model we got in the last patch, where it becomes more accurate the longer you shoot. This is to prevent this tank loadout to delete infantry instantly the moment you see them. I think this nerf may be a little harsh, but I want you to wait and see how it actually performs in game. I think Dice will be open to further adjustments if it instantly becomes useless, and also, the anti-air and anti-tank capabilities should be unchanged. But not all hope is lost. I think many people found that the coaxial guns became absolutely rubbish since the last update, and when I show this clip to Dice, they sort of agree that even I was on the objective, I was still having trouble killing these infantry with the coaxial. I pretty much killed all of them with my main gun. So we will be seeing a buff. Basically, the 4 bullet to kill range will be extended from 12 meters to 30 meters, and then the drop off to 8 bullets to kill will be extended from 75 meters to 100 meters. This is going to match the drop-off range for the MG34, which is a good thing. Now, next thing would be the change to the infantry anti-tank weapons. AT mines and dynamites will now deal slightly less damage than before. AT mines will receive a much more hit in damage and actually dealing less than the dynamites, but it will have an increased chance to disable tanks, tracks, and engines. As a matter of fact, you will actually have a 100% chance of disabling a tank's track if they roll onto just one of them. AT mines will also now do a maximum of 28 damage to light tanks, 25 to medium, and 20 to heavy tanks. Dynamites will do a maximum of 42 damage to light tanks, 38 to medium, and 30 to heavy tanks. The number of these explosives carried by assault players will be unchanged. But in the case of the AT mines, you can put down 6 of them at a time before they disappear given you resupply a couple of times. This means you can put 3 on one lane and then 3 on another, or just 6 in the same spots. As for the range gadgets, because of the changes in angles for tanks, these will also be affected. It will now require better angles to deal massive hits to tanks similar to the tank shells. Panzerfaust will do less damage than the Piat by a good margin, but of course they are easier to use. It will do a maximum of 25 damage if you land one of these on a medium tank's engine, whereas a Piat can do as much as 45 damage, and the AT pistol can deal the least at 22 damage. So what do I think of these changes? I will first have to preface by saying that my impression will be based solely on looking at these numbers. I have not played it or anything like that, so my impression may not paint the most accurate picture. But looking at these numbers, I can sort of give an educated guess. So this update changes a lot of things. It made tank versus tank combats a lot more straightforward without as much nuances in the mechanics. Like first of all, knowing what angle is the best and then actually executing it. The focus of tank versus tank combats will now shift towards more macroscopic tactics like movement, situational awareness, and flanks. An experienced tanker will now be slightly less successful at face tanking an enemy tank simply by harnessing the power of armor angling. That's not to say it is not effective, but just nowhere near as much as before. With this change, it will now allow new tank users to not get destroyed by an experienced user as quickly in a 1v1 face-to-face tank fight. But if you are able to flank them and hit them in their rear, then they may die faster than before. But I'm sure that tank versus tank combat is not the concern for most tankers to begin with. The majority of the tankers' complaints lie on the fact that infantry players can easily destroy their tanks unless they stay all the way back from the action, leading to a campy playstyle. And with this update, tankers may see a slight increase in survivability against infantry at a distance because of a decrease in damage of ranged AT gadgets. But if the infantry players are able to get close to the enemy tank, it can still be devastating to the tanks because of the improved ability for infantry to immobilize tanks with the new AT mines. They can do a ton of damage to tanks' rear with more explosive and rockets. But that's not all bad news against infantry. I've heard that internal playtests from DICE appear to have found that tanks are able to escape from an objective easier if they become overrun. Also, tank's turret has seen a decreased reduction in turn speed from being disabled in the 5.0 patch from negative 75% to negative 25%. The coaxial machine guns will also see a slight buff from a drastic nerf we received in the 5.0 patch. The blast radius for most HE shells will also see an improvement of roughly 8% and 14% for the Panzer IV and Stuk IV's L37 HE shell, which is a short barrel. And I personally play the objective even in the current build quite extensively, but an average tanker may find this difficult. This patch aims to especially help those players to survive longer against other tanks and other infantry. DICE should be monitoring the changes and will continue adjusting areas that seem inadequate. The actual goal of the tank overhaul should be to empower tankers to play the objective more, and that is not to say you need to be in the middle of the objective at all times, because that is simply not smart. Whether this patch is enough to encourage tankers to actually change their playstyle and push the objective without an immense fear of no return the moment they attack has yet to be determined. In cases where further adjustments may be needed, I think DICE should be open to continue adjusting the values to help find the right balance. And that's it for the video. Let me know what you think down in the comment section. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, if not, a thumbs down. Feel free to follow me on Twitter and join my Discord channel, links are down below. I would also appreciate it immensely if you decide to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell for notification. Otherwise, have a tanktastic day, and I will see you again soon.